In this video, we are going to explore the rules for exponents, and we're also going to look at some order of operations and how that affects what we do. The first example on this page is 7 squared, 7 raised to a power of 2. And as you recall, the base is 7 and the exponent is 2, and this tells us to multiply the base by itself 2 times. 7 times 7 is 49, positive. In the second example, we have a set of parentheses around negative 7, and that is raised to a power of 2. And I'm just going to ask you to recall your order of operations where parentheses is the first operation. And what that means in this example is everything inside the parentheses is going to be raised to that power of 2. So we have a base of negative 7 and an exponent of 2. And this one is telling us to multiply negative 7 by itself 2 times, and negative 7 times negative 7 is positive 49. Now it changes a little bit in the third example, and I'm going to put the PEMDAS in front of you again. Notice that E, exponent, is the second in the order of operations. If there's no parentheses there, your exponent is going to be very particular about the base. In this example, we've got a negative out in front that's not contained by parentheses. That negative is actually an extra factor of negative 1. So we have an extra factor of negative 1 multiplied by this base of 7, and that base of 7 is raised to an exponent of 2. What that looks like if you write it out is negative 1 times 7 times 7, and if you were to multiply the two positive 7s together, you would get positive 49. But the negative 1 actually gets to multiply in at the end there, and your final answer is negative 49. So keep that in mind as you work on these, that order of operations really matters in these expressions. Namely, a pair of parentheses really makes a difference in how you solve the problem. In these three examples, we're going to look at negative exponents with the order of operations. And we're going to follow a negative exponent rule, which informally says that when you have negative exponents in a numerator, they will get moved to the denominator and become positive exponents. So what that means for the first example, 7 to the negative 2, is that 7 to the negative 2 is actually considered to be in the numerator of a fraction, and we can move the expression to the denominator of a fraction and change the negative 2 exponent to a positive 2 exponent. Because this is now in the denominator of the fraction, we need to fill the numerator with a 1, so it'll be 1 over 7 squared. And then you would just evaluate normally. You would multiply 7 times 7 in the denominator, and your final answer would be 1 over 49. The second example, the parentheses around negative 7 raised to the negative 2 power, we're going to do the same thing. The entire expression, because of parentheses, is raised to this negative 2 power, so we'll move the entire expression to the denominator. We're not going to change the negative 7 inside the parentheses, but we will change the exponent from a negative 2 to a positive 2, and we will fill the numerator with a 1. And this time we will multiply two negative 7s together in the denominator, and our final answer is again a positive 1 over 49. In the third example, we have that lack of parentheses again. So in this case, the negative and the 7 and raised to the negative 2 power is all in the numerator, but just that base of 7 gets to move with that exponent of negative 2 to the denominator of the fraction. The negative stays up there. The outside factor will stay in the numerator. We'll change the negative 2 to a positive 2 and put a 1 in the numerator, and that will give us a negative 1 in the numerator, and then go ahead and multiply your two 7s together in the denominator, and your final answer will be a negative 1 over 49, which is more commonly written with the negative out to the side. I'm going to give you two more examples with which you can explore that negative exponent rule. In the first example, we have negative 3 times 2 raised to the negative 2 power. And negative 3 is an extra factor. It's a lot more obvious than just a negative out in front. So we're going to write that as negative 3 times 2 to the negative power over a denominator, because we want to move 2 to the negative power to the denominator so that we can change that negative 2 exponent to a positive 2 exponent. If we write this further, that's a negative 3 over 2 squared, or 2 times 2, and that becomes negative 3 over 4. You could also write that as the negative out in front with 3 over 4. The second example is 4x to the negative 8. And you will consider 4 and x to the negative 8 right now to be in the numerator. The x to the negative 8 needs to move to the denominator so that that can become a positive 8. And then the final answer here is 4 over x to the 8th power. I'm going to give you a chance to pause the video so that you can do a little bit of work on these and then check your answer. So go ahead and pause the video. And here are your answers. The first one is a positive 4 over 25. The second one, that negative carries through, and it's negative 2 over x to the 6th. And the third one, what happens is the negative does get moved to the denominator, and then 3 negative 2's multiply together give you negative 8. So the final answer on that one is negative 1 over 8. Good luck as you continue to practice the skill.